I'm Dwayne Lard, and I teach construction technology at Crockett High School and also some classes here at ACC. This is a continuation of our speed square. We're going to be using this speed square and cut rafters out, or design a rafter to fit our needs.
And what are rafters for?
Rafters, good question. Rafters are the structural member that actually support the roof of a house. So the first thing we need to do is understand pitch or slope. Actually, the slope of roof is the correct term. Pitch is what is typically used by the architects. What that is if we have a house, then this right here is the rafter, and there's an angle that goes across here, and we need find a way that we can describe that is a universal term so that everyone can understand what the roof pitch is of any particular structure. So this is a graph that you may recognize. And when you're talking about a roof slope or roof pitch, then it's always described in terms of you're going to be running over a certain distance, and then you're going to be rising a certain distance, and that will define the roof pitch or the roof slope. The standard, the trade standard, is you're going to be running over 12 units. It could be 12 inches or it could be 12 feet, but it's 12 units. Whatever the units are here, you have to use the same units here. In other words, if it's feet here that you're talking, then you have to use feet here, or inches. But 12 is always the unit that you're going to be running over. So in this case, I've got 12 marks across here. To describe a roof slope, if I'm going over 12, that, and I come up 2, then this is what the roof pitch looks like, or the roof slope. If I'm going to come over 5, or up 5, then that's what the angle is. Let's go 8. So this is the way that you describe a roof pitch or roof slope. Architects use a graphic, and they say typically the pitch is equal, in this case, 8, 12, which means that is your rise over your run. And again, when you're talking about this, the run is always going to be units of 12, or 12 units over. And then the number of units up you go, that's going to be the rise, and that's going to be the visual, the description of how, what the slope of the roof is. Well, now comes the question, how long is a rafter? So in order to figure that out, we have to do math. This is one of your favorite formulas, I know. So we're going to be using this to figure out the length of our rafter. If we look carefully, we can see that that is the hypotenuse of a right triangle. These letters, A, B, and C, into carpenter's words so that we can work our problem. So now I've changed this into rafter squared, and it says A squared plus b squared equals our rafter squared. So to understand this, we have to do a little bit of vocabulary. The distance between your support walls outside to outside is called the span. And you can find the span on your set of blueprints. It'll say this building is exactly this wide. So no matter what it is, that's what your span is. Your span by definition, one half of your span is going to be equal to our run. And this is going to be our rise. So you see, one half our span is our run, and then this is our rise. So if we're substituting in our carpenter words for the Pythagorean theorem, we have our run squared plus our rise squared is now equal to our rafter squared. And that will tell us exactly how long this rafter is. Anytime I have a value, a numerical value for one of my words, then I come over here and I substitute in that value into this formula. So now I've got my run is 14 squared plus, I don't know what my rise is. But the architect will tell us on the plans exactly what our pitch is. So we don't know what our pitch is at 14 feet. Right here is 12. We know that at 12 feet, we're going up 5 feet. But we're going over here 14 feet, so our rise is going to change a little bit. The way that we figure this out is we work a formula. So, there's our formula. We know this to be true because the architect told us. Now, like I said before, anytime you see a word that has a numerical value, then we can substitute that in because our run is 14 feet, and so now we can substitute that in. Now we have an algebraic equation with one unknown. And in order to solve that, I'll do it by cross multiplying. So it says when I'm running over 14 feet on this particular situation, I'm going to be going up 5.8333 feet. So again, anytime I have a numerical value for one of my words, I just plug it right in. Keeping in mind that in the earlier conversation, I want to leave this. I don't want to convert my engineer scale into my architectural scale because I can do this math easier than converting 0.833 feet into feet and inches. So I'm going to do the math. Okay. So this tells me that my rafter now is 15.1667 feet. So that's what this is. If my span is 14 feet and if my rise is 5.8333 feet. So now, and I don't have this measurement on my tape measure, so I have to convert this into my architectural scale. Okay, so there's the math. So now what we'll do is we'll go out and I'll show you how to mark a rafter.